Hello, everyone. Thank you for inviting me at this third annual Pandemic and Biosecurity Forum in Washington, D.C. This presentation is entitled Ebola Response, Overview and Thoughts for Effective Pandemic Response. Ebola virus disease is a very serious, highly contagious viral disease with a very high lethality rate. It is governed by the international health regulation since there is a high probability to get it spread across national boundaries. From 1976 to 2018, the DRC has been affected by 10 epidemics, almost all in rural areas. The current epidemic is more special because it affects two provinces at the same time in both urban and rural areas, with a large number of victims, around 65% of deaths, according to the MOH, April 28th. The Ministry of Health and its partners have developed several strategies that are proved ineffective, according to the third strategic plan of January 2019. Despite the deployed human resources, both national and international, with high expertise, the epidemic continues with approximately the average of 100 new positive victims, sometimes even more every week. Big questions in national public opinion as well as in international are: when will the epidemic end? Why is it so long to end the epidemic? This presentation proposes to answer the questions with series of reflections and arguments called explanatory factors resulting from some exchanges and interviews. To respond to the need of systematization, explanatory factors have been subdivided into geographical, cultural, social, anthropological, security, and economic factors. The North Kivu province is dealing with the Ebola outbreak since August 2018. It started in Mangina village, 25 kilometers west of Beni city in North Kivu. This disease has soon spread in the other villages of Beni territory, Beni city, and Butembo only 1 month after. Today, the epidemic has reached 12 health zones in the northern part of the North Kivu province, an area mainly under control of the armed groups and undergoing several militia attacks and murders, especially in Beni, since 2014. This part of North Kivu has 90% Nande population, whose main activities are subsistence farming and trade, with a focus on self-satisfaction, and has no experience to depend on government or NGOs' aid. The population in Butembo and around characterized by economic sense, conservative, sometimes listen without reaction, no public leisure, too much modesty, has problems to perceive the Ebola virus disease due to certain reasons and practices of the response agents, as well as the rumors around this disease, especially that the first people to talk about it were only foreigners, which is normal because the region had not experienced the Ebola epidemic before. In Butembo and around, merchants participate in the big decisions of the city, but they have not been associated. It should also be noted that some traders collaborate with armed groups so their commerce continues to flourish in town without threats. The facts of not being associated in the response and not in anything, any interests with the very high rates of stubble, the population thinks of a complicity of extermination. Transportation costs were reimbursed to participants at each awareness meeting, and sometimes they were fed, which had never been a habit for health issues. Until these days, teams are accompanied by the militaries and police in the community. This was and still seen by the population as a politicization of the response activities, especially since the militaries and police in DRC are accused in several human rights violations and to massacre the population in the region under the command of certain Farisi and police officers, as well as rebels. And the last regime is bad memoried by the population for the idea to keep the last president in power. That was proved when the last elections of December 31st, 2018 were postponed in the region due to the Ebola outbreak. Ebola is just a continuation of the massacre, according to the population. The doctors, sensitizers, and other agents were only foreigners who know no spoken languages in the area. Explanations about this new disease in the area exceed the expectations of the residents, especially when the response agents do leisure prostitution, shake hands, what they prohibit the residents. Several people, including those who do know anything, came from all over to enjoy this manner of money from the response. This is also another reason to say that international were only or are only there searching for money. Ebola's disease comes in a very insecure zone with massacre without any single assistance from the same organizations that are financially supporting the Ebola outbreak in a very poor and underemployed community. Local doctors, especially in the rural areas, are for the most part out of care and know practically nothing of what happens when they have the confidence of the population. The spread of the epidemic is facilitated first by the proximity and density of the populations in the zone, but also the movement of the population, in addition to the habit to go to the care only after an attempt of self-medication home that sometimes takes a week or more. As a result, many patients are hidden in the households and die contaminating family members. Of course, the population does not really understand a disease that can decimate as many people in a few days. They still think of an international planning of extermination, kind same as the massacre in the Beni and Lubero areas, especially that as much attention has never been observed in this question of the insecurity in the zone. Ebola with a lot of money comes to meet a bruised community with all the difficulties of life. It is all these elements that cause too much resistance, and it is the leading cause of the Ebola treatment centers' attacks and the aversion against the agents of the response and all activities. This makes some foreigner afraid to get in the community for investigations and are not effective. We also understand that people, even doctors who get the information on television or radio about the amount of money that is made for the response, all want to get benefit from it. The author of The Resistance, once hired, the resistance stops. It is an employment opportunity for both national, international and local people, but the problem is also that the internationals have a per diem out of the salary, which is worth 10 times the local agent's salary. The response needs everyone's help from everywhere, but it would not be a problem if the national and international kept low profile and just coordinate the local people with the experience. Epidemiologically, it is necessary to break and stop the transmission chain by vaccination, decontamination, to care the patients at the ETC, follow up and oversee the contacts. In the community, practice washing rules, washing hands regularly with soap and water. Do not shake one's hands. Alert about all suspects, deaths, and visitors. Do not unsecure burials. Accept vaccinations and follow up for 21 days. In addition, the success of a healthcare management activity requires certain requirements, such as good coordination, strategic concerted plan of the partners, decentralization, integration of the healthcare system, and ownership of the population. The healthcare in the ETC is a big challenge. If several patients die of delayed care, some others died of hypoglycemia, lack of psychological care and support. Health structures have difficulties to dealing with contagious disease following the lack of isolation services for patients at risk of infections. This means that the structures should be provided with structural support for isolations, personal protective equipment for medical staff, and permanent triage services. The government also seems to be abandoning the teams bi-weekly and with impunity watching the teams suffer from violence, the certain population and members of armed groups inflicts on the response agents and prevent the smooth running of the response activities. The government must take its responsibilities. Ownership is the essential part of the response to the Ebola virus disease. The public must understand that EVD is a public health problem with the potential to kill many people and make it a pandemic. All the channels of communication must be used to make the risk understood, with the community participation estimated at 70% of the response. If the population understands the risk, it will appropriate the response and do everything to avoid it. The other important aspect that can restore the confidence is to fund the possibility of the Ebola vaccination campaign for the whole population, to create employment through NGOs in different projects and development sectors. Perhaps we could experiment the coordination of the activities implemented on the ground by the locals, and that after the coaching with the experience international and national. Finally, whatever the official status of this outbreak is, it is clear that the outbreak is not under control and therefore it needs a better collective effort. The Ebola virus disease has not spread to neighboring countries so far, but the possibility exists. What is most important now is to make efforts to gain control of the epidemic, is to change the way people are dealing with it. There is a real need to adapt the intervention to the needs and expectations of the population, to integrate Ebola activities in the local healthcare system, to engage effectively with the communities and to further explore promising vaccinations to strengthen prevention. The choices must be given back to the patients and their families on how to manage the disease, for example, by allowing people to seek healthcare in their local centers rather than in an Ebola treatment center. This needs health centers to get specific infrastructures and equipment as said above here. Thank you.